Sammy Woodhouse came to me 2 or 3 years ago now and spoke to me about her horrific experience in the family courts, where the man who'd raped her and was currently serving a prison sentence, a 35-year prison sentence, had been encouraged to apply through the family courts for access to her child. That led her and I to start a campaign with other survivors of domestic abuse to give them better protections in the family courts. And after raising it many, many times in Parliament and talking about it on the media, we got the government to set up a review, which took evidence from thousands of victims and expert organisations. And then as a result of that, today they have announced that they're bringing in changes that will protect victims better. So they're going to strengthen what's known as barring orders, which will prevent abusive ex-partners constantly using the courts as a weapon to re-traumatise their victims. They're going to put in place just really basic things like allowing victims to come in through separate entrances to the court, and so that they don't have to be in the same room as or be near their ex-partner when they're trying to get into court. And it will look at the presumption that currently exists that says a child must have a relationship with both parents, because as has been proven, there have been several children that have sadly, tragically been murdered by parents following forced contact with the family courts, even where they are a known risk. So they're going to look at reversing that presumption, so that first and foremost, the child's welfare is prioritised, not just a blanket assumption that they should have a relationship with both parents.
How will these new rules really impact on the victims of abuse?
I genuinely think it's not an over exaggeration to say it will change people's lives.